I want to go back.
He wants to go back.
I want to go back to the farm.
Go back far away from home. With a milk pail on my arm.
I miss the rooster, the one that used to wake me up at 4 a.m.
Down on the farm.
I'm Scott Baim. They call me the old farmer. I wanted to remind everybody to make sure that you have the proper fire extinguishers throughout your homestead or your home. We have three fire extinguishers. One is here right next to the kitchen, and we have one in the basement, and we have one in the garage. Now, this fire extinguisher that I showed you had a plastic wall mount for it. It literally broke and fell on the floor. So after arguing with Kidda, they finally sent out only one, since I bought 2 5-pounders at the same time. They'd only send out one that would actually work. And I'm going to use 2.5-inch decking screws with washers on them to mount this thing in place. And then I'm going to have to, with my own money, go out and replace the other holder for the one in the basement. I just don't like things that I have to fiddle with when there shouldn't be. There's a difference between having to do scheduled maintenance. That's not what I'm talking about. But I'm talking about a bad design. I had to call the store where we got it at, and then they said call Kidda. First time they sent out the wrong holder for it, would not hold it. Then second time I called, the guy basically wanted to go on his break and didn't do anything and basically hung up on me. And the third time I called and explained the situation that their plastic wall mounts are designed wrong and fire extinguishers can just fall off the wall. And yeah, this one fell off the wall. I was in our family room. All of a sudden I heard this big crash, and I went to investigate, and it was sitting on the floor with a broken wall bracket on it. So we got only one wall bracket. We'll replace that one, and then I'll have to buy one all by myself and go through all the hassles of dealing with getting what needed to be with a fire extinguisher in the first place. So, Kidda, your fire extinguishers are about the same as anybody else's. Nothing to get excited about, but they do the job. This is a 5-pound ABC that I purchased. I purchased 2 of them, but they put the cheesiest wall mounts on it, and now I had to take the old one off. I had to call 3 times. I have to put the thing back up. I'm not here to complain about Kidda, but it makes me think twice before I would buy one of their products. If they can't build it right, then how can I trust them? So this is a 5-pound ABC. I mounted the wall bracket. Now I'm going to hang it back up, and it's a little tricky getting the strap in place, but you can do it, and it holds it securely in place. Now, I suggest that you have a fire extinguisher, a 5-pound ABC, on every floor in your house, and also one in your garage. In fact, I might even replace the one that I have in the garage with a 10-pound fire extinguisher. Now, depending on what your concerns are, for example, if you do mechanical stuff in your garage, you may want to get a bicarbonate fire extinguisher and a 10-pound one at that. But for most people, the ABC fire extinguisher is the one that you want to have most of the time. So they'll take care of all the fires that you will have. But think of it as talcum powder. It will be going over all over the place if you have to use it. But it's a good fire extinguisher. I have put out huge fires with a 5-pound ABC, and I suggest that everyone consider putting one in and be familiar with how to use a fire extinguisher. So this is the old farmer, Scott Baim, saying be well.
Life's good.
Down on the farm.
Thank you.